In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Bestower of Mercy. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah wa ba'd. All praise is due to Allah, and may the blessings and peace be upon the final messenger, Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Wa ba'd, to proceed where we left off in a series of lectures from the book Al-Aqidatu Sahiha wa ma yudadduha, the correct belief and what opposes it. And we advise everyone, and we advise all the viewers to get the book, or get this short treatise written by Imam Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, the famous and noble scholar. And it's an online book publication of www.alibana.com. So anyone who wants to get the book can get the book online to look at these points regarding the correct belief in the correct Islam. We left off in the belief in Allah. The author said, "This is the creed." This, meaning this, what we mentioned in the last lecture, Sheikh Abu Bakr, about distorting their meanings, meaning the names and attributes of Allah, distorting their meanings and denying them and describing their manner or making similarities to them. The author said, "This is the creed and belief of Ahlul Sunnah." Meaning to not do this. This is the creed and belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The question is, Sheikh Abu Bakr, who are Ahlul Sunnah? What is the Sunnah, and who are Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah?
Alright, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Praise be to Allah, the cherisher, the sustainer of everything. And the peace and blessings be upon his final Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thank you very much, Mr. Ammar, to this good introduction and to the advice that you give to the viewers to get the book, which is, can be accessed easily online, because it's a very important book, especially for those who are interested to know the basics of Islam and the faith in Allah and the six pillars of Iman and the five pillars of Islam, and so on. This or all these basics of Islam, this book is very beneficial for this knowledge. Then concerning the questions that you have said, the creed of Ahlul Sunnah, which the Imam Ibn Baz mentioned here and refer to what we have talked about last time, when it comes to the perfect names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God. He said this is the creed of Ahlul Sunnah. The creed means approach or the way of Ahlul Sunnah. And as Sunnah means the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, those who live with him, and the believers in Allah and in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Muslims at that time. The creed of Ahlul Sunnah, or the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this approach of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, which include all the actions, belief, statements, and everything that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam does, and everything that he commanded or he ordered his companions to do, Sahaba at that time, and the way of thinking, the way of getting knowledge, the way of studying Islam, the way of performing, the way of how they establish prayer, how they, and so on. This is called the creed of Ahlul Sunnah, the general approach, the way of knowing, and the way of performing, and the way of implementing Islam itself. This is the creed of Ahl Sunnah. Also, our Prophet Muhammad has a prophecy concerning this area. He told us a historical circle news which is very important. He said that Jews before us split into 71 sects, and Christian after them split into the 72 sects. And this Ummah, this is a prophecy, this Ummah will split into 73 sects. All of these sects who are deviators from the way of the Prophet and his companions, all of these sects will be in the hellfire except one. So at that time, Sahaba immediately asked him about this one who is saved. He told them that this one who is saved is those who are in what I am now and my companions. He didn't mention that this safe sect is the sect which has a particular name, nor he mentioned that this sect has a particular place where they will be in. He also didn't order any one of his companions to follow a certain way that which is different from what he does at that time. Okay, so if you want to know this is this saved group or sect, you have to know that this is the group of people who do what, or their belief, their actions, statements, and everything in concerning the religious thinking or the religious instruction should be similar to what our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has done. I mean, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah does not mean that they are a certain group that lives in a particular place or has a particular name or certain maybe follow a person particularly in name. No, can be found everywhere, but the condition is that they should be, or they have in their belief and their statement and actions similar to what our Prophet was. Yes.
So the author said this is the creed and belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, as Sheikh Abu Bakr mentioned. So we can be, anyone can be from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah even in this time.
Exactly.
Even in this time, anyone can be from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah if yes, they follow these correct beliefs.
Yes.
From the companions of Allah's Messenger and those who succeeded them upon goodness, which you mentioned. And this is what Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, may Allah have mercy on him, who is also another scholar, a noble scholar of Islam, reported in his book Al-Maqalat an Ashab al-Hadith wa Ahl al-Sunnah, as did other scholars. Sheikh Abu Bakr, can you tell us who Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari is? What is exactly his methodology? Is he from what we mentioned? Is he from Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah?
Exactly. Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari was one of the scholars or predecessors who was in the third generation, or the glorifying third generation, because our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that the best generation overall is my generation, and the best generation after my generation is the generation that follow my generation, and so on up to three generations. Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari lived in the third generation, and he was one of the well-known scholars of Islam. And at the first or the second, he has three stages in his life. The first stage was one of Al-Mu'tazila, It is an innovatory group. And then he changed from Al-Mu'tazila to something else called Al-Ash'ariya. Al-Ash'ariya. And he has the belief, the way of believing or a methodology of one so-called Ibn Kulab. This is the second stage of his life. And then finally he left all these stages to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah and became one of the scholars and well-known scholars of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. But nowadays those who think that, who consider themselves as a Sharia, and they think that they follow Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari as he was well-known scholar and great alim and imam of the Muslim scholars. Those who think that they are al-Ash'ariya, they follow the second stage of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, which he left and became one of Ahlul Sunnah. Those who are al-Ash'ariya nowadays, who are Sufists, and the follow or the text methodology of Sufism, or the way of Sufism, which is completely deviating from Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah. But those who follow Al-Ash'ari nowadays are not actually following Al-Ash'ari, but actually they are following who is called Ibn Kulab. So they are actually Kulabiyya, not Ash'ariya, because Al-Ash'ari has left. What they taking now, Al-Ash'ari has left.
He repented from it.
So Al-Ash'ari is one of the scholars from Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He has a similar belief to all the other scholars like Imam Malik, Ibn Anas, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and so on. Yes.
The author continued to say, Al-Awza'i, may Allah have mercy on him, said Az-Zuhri and Makhul,
who are well-known scholars.
Who are all well-known scholars of Islam.
When we say As-Salaf, those who followed our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his companions in the way, these are As-Salaf. Examples for As-Salaf, Al-Awza'i, Al-Zubri, Makhul, all that well-known scholars are As-Salaf, are Salafists.
Here, so the author said about all these well-known scholars and scholars of Islam and Salaf, our pious predecessors, he said, were asked about the verses regarding Allah's attributes. So they replied, leave them as they have been reported.
Leave them as they have been reported.
As they have been reported.
A very excellent answer. And this what we have explained last time, that leave the verses that speaks about the verses that mention Allah's perfect names and attributes, leave them as they are, without distorting their meaning, without takyif, without tamthil, resembling, without changing their meaning. Leave them as they are. Allah says that He has written over His throne, says, okay, Allah has written over His throne, without changing the meaning, without saying that it doesn't have any meaning. Doesn't have any meaning.
Strong.
Without resembling, without takif, without ta'til, leave them as they are.
The author continued to mention some of the noble scholars of Islam. He said, Al-Walid ibn Muslim, may Allah have mercy on him, said, Malik, Al-Awza'i, Al-Layth ibn Sa'd, and Sufyan al-Thawri.
These are well-known and very famous scholars. These are very famous scholars. Each one of them may have his own approach in fiqh. They have approaches in fiqh, which is followed by their students. So they are well-known scholars. So if you have a similar belief to all these scholars, And those who has taken their belief and iman and their understanding from the Prophet and his companions. So this means that the creed of Ahl Sunnah is the creed that follows the Prophet and his companions. So here the author mentioned Makhud al-Zuhri, al-Imam Malik. So very well known and famous scholars. This means that this kind of these types of belief or this faith is inherited from our predecessors.
So here the author Imam Abdul Aziz ibn Baz mentioned these scholars and he said they were asked about the texts that were reported concerning Allah's attributes. So they all said, leave them as they have been reported without describing how they are. Without describing how they are.
Here outlines this a quoted sentence outlines the fact that without describing how they are, which was outlined last time in our last lecture, that you leave them as they are without describing. Don't say that Allah looks like so and so, Allah's attribute looks like so and so, Allah's face looks like so and so, Allah's hand looks like so and so. No, we believe that Allah has a hand, we believe that Allah has a face. We will, as it is reported in the Holy Quran and the authentic Sunnah, but we cannot say and we shouldn't say that Allah's hands look like so and so. This is unlawful. Okay, and generally, this is the approach of Ahl Sunnah, the way or the creed of Ahl Sunnah, which has two or three main pillars. If you want to follow Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, you have to put in your mind that there are three main important things that you should follow. You have to take all your belief and way of worshipping from the Noble Quran, from the authentic Sunnah. Number one, the Noble Quran. Number two, the authentic Sunnah. And number three, according these texts which are taken from the Holy Quran and the authentic Sunnah should be understood according to the way or the approach of these scholars who followed the companions of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the companions who followed the way of our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So our belief and our thing, our worship, everything is inherited by this way. Every one of us inherit it from those who predecess him or precede him, the predecessors over us. We take from them and they take from this, those who are above them and so on until all of us take from our Prophet Muhammad.
Lastly, the author mentions, he said, anyone that opposes Ahl Sunnah or those who are those who follow the Prophet and the pious predecessors, anyone who opposes Ahl Sunnah and what they believe regarding the subject of Allah's names and attributes, no doubt will fall into opposing the textual and logical evidences while having clear contradictions in everything that he affirms and negates. So what do you have to say?
I think this speech which is quoted from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, Ahmad ibn Abdul Halim ibn Abdul Salam, it's a very excellent quotation from Ibn Taymiyyah, which explains that or clarify that everyone who deviates from the approach of Ahl Sunnah or from the creed of Ahl Sunnah will fall into contradiction. Will fall into contradiction because the creed of Ahl Sunnah is based on the Holy Quran and the authentic Sunnah and the understanding of the holy people, of the honorable people who lived or who accompanied the Prophet Muhammad. So if you deviate from this and if you try to make yourself better than them and more knowledgeable than them, this means that you have an opinion against the Holy Quran. You have an opinion or ideology against the Holy Quran and the authentic Sunnah. so that you will fall certainly and actually you will fall in contradiction. Because the Quran is true, the Holy Quran is, the Noble Quran is true, and the authentic Sunnah is true. It is revealed to our Prophet Muhammad from Allah, Almighty Allah. So it's true, and the Holy Quran is true, and the understanding of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is true, because they learn it from the Prophet Muhammad. So if you try to be against them, if you try to make yourself or to pretend that you are better than them, this means that you will certainly, surely fall in contradiction. So this quoted speech, which is taken from Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, Allah may shower his blessing on him, is an excellent speech which describes precisely those who oppose Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah.
Thank you very much. I think we can conclude here and continue inshallah in a series of lectures from this book, Al-Aqidatu Sahiha wa ma yudadduha, the correct belief and what opposes it. Wa alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah, wallahu alam.